Take a look at this.
It took the ship. All meat.
This recipe looks real tasty.
Scout ship setting sail.
Then, what was I doing?
I lost a bet to a young man, and he dared me to prove my courage by sailing out to a class 4 island. Now, I can handle myself, but man, it ain't fun and games there. I nearly got killed by demons.
You actually stepped foot on a class 4 island?
Not even. I was still approaching it by ship when this stuff that looked like spider silk started spreading round. These bug-looking demons were using the stuff to try and climb aboard my ship. Damnation! The crew cut those threads as fast as anything, and we got the hell out of there. Whole thing left me bawling.
Well, I'm glad to see you made it out safely. I'd suggest not going near there again.
Oh no, I wasn't planning on it. I had enough of that place to last me a lifetime.
Yeah, we got now. New class 4. And I haven't visited even the first one yet. Hello, Toiltans. Do you have anything new to sell? No. Oh, there is one. Excuse me. Oh, there is something there. I mean someone. So this way. Can't pick it up. Cat poop. Can't carry. There's something here. Can't get that. Pin up. Maybe that way. Aha! It was in the inn. is it? No, it's not the inn. What? No voice acting. Okay. Medical worker. I can prepare a patch if you need rest. Why not?
The oldest known map of the world was made by... Wow! It took them decades!
You always look so happy when you've got your nose in a book. What's so interesting about the one you've got there?
It's a book about surveying. When I read it, I can imagine myself traveling afar and making maps of the world. It sounds like so much fun.
I know just how you feel. I know Mogilu and the others don't understand. But I just can't help but feel excited when I think about us completing a map of the entire world.
It's the thought of treasure that gets me more fired up!
Obviously, there's treasure waiting to be unearthed too, but that's more of a bonus on the side. Crossing uncrossable oceans, going to lands where none have gone before. The voyage itself, the dance with death, these things hold value greater than that of any treasure.
Ah, adventure! Truly the romance of the quest we call life.
Lafayette, you had a map, didn't you? The one you dropped when we first met?
It's a world map I got when I was with the Abbey, but I only checked out the places really close by. I could hardly call it adventure.
There's more to adventuring than visiting far-off lands and sailing stormy seas, you know. Adventures are about achieving your ambitions and leaping across the walls we've built to protect ourselves, no matter the danger that waits on the other side. There are no big or small adventures.
Even if I only went to Helavies and the Fegal Ice Caps?
Think of it like this. When you sneaked out of town without the Abbey noticing, when you walked the land and compared it to your map, how did that make you feel?
It was scary, but fun. Exhilarating.
Then it was an adventure. The map you made within yourself is a treasure that's only yours.
Wow! My very own treasure! Whoa! Awesome!
I swear. The second he has a spare moment, he buries himself in his books.
Knowledge opens up bigger worlds. I imagine that back when Teresa was bossing him around, reading was a fun escape, an adventure in and of itself.
Hmm? What's up, you guys?
You're reading a pretty hard book there, aren't you?
This? It's about dinosaurs. It says that long before humans were around, these huge creatures ruled the world. There are so many different kinds, like tyrannosaurs and triceratops and brachiosaurs. They're all so cool.
They look like dragons to me.
They look similar, but dinosaurs couldn't live inside volcanoes, and they didn't do well in the cold either. But they were crazy huge and strong. Nothing else could even compete with them.
I bet they would have made for great sparring partners. I think this Gigantospinosaurus might be my favorite.
Those two huge points jutting out from both sides of its body make it look just like you and your two swords.
Actually, it's also known as the dual-bladed dragon.
Wow, it really does sound like a perfect match for me then.
Okay, so if they weren't dragons, what were they?
They look a lot like lizards.
Maybe they're like my ancestors or something.
But you used to be a human.
Damn, I think I might have gotten a bit too used to this new body of mine.
I wonder if their tails can fall off too.
Okay, those kids are done. Collect everything. What was this? Can't collect. Okay, then bum 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 bum. Let's try to go to B. one for now. There is a couple of places I haven't been yet. And that's the problem, because it doesn't take that much time. I want to explore. If it actually is like going blim blim. This way. But I am just doing the story bits. Nothing more. Nothing less. Ah, I sneezed. There was a plant, so it was still was worth to come here. What the heck? Echinos. Ah. This is more of the prison. Can't see anything here. No. It would be very cruel if this kind of place was had a very cheapest jump scare and this kind of music. Ah. Ah. I'm sorry. But it was worth to come here. Was still good to come here. Then B2. How do I? Out of path, okay. I just want to get everything. Even if it's just minor stuff. Out of path. Yes. Yes. This way. pum pum.
Looks like you'd like this island. Fly free, noble hawk. Hunt to your heart's content, Grocky.
Grocky?
His name is Grocky? Is Grocky his name? No, it's merely a nickname for the noble Sir Hawk Griffin here. Oh, he's a hawk, so you call him Hawky, Grocky. That's right. The one who trained him said that hawks are just tools for hunting, and I shouldn't get attacked. But still, well, I felt he was close companion, and I wanted to give him a nickname like friends are want to do. Haha, not a very princely behavior, I know. Oh, I beg for to disagree, and I think Sir Hawk Griffin does too. Sure is it? It didn't know birds could be knighted. I didn't know either. And then, biggest question. Was that all? So-called optional stuff. I think it was. I think this was the right way. I hope. Because I was supposed to go down. Yes. Just hide. Nothing. This was the prison Velvet was kept captive for, was it 2-3 years? So this is in where Velvet Revenge started.
We're here. What now?
Well, so I've been thinking about Earth Pulse points. They're where the flow of the Earth pulse, the Earth's natural forces, are concentrated.
Right. And Innominat is using those points to acquire malevolence and reawaken himself. You seem to have a knack for sensing them out. Once you're close enough, you can even pinpoint their location.
Except, I don't have to be close at all. When we came here yesterday, I felt another place. A place just like this.
Are you saying you can use this Earth Pulse point as a conduit to find the others?
I think so. I don't know how far it works, and I can't say if Etherian will be on the other end.
Still, it'll give us something real to go on. Please, give it a try.
Okay.
Anything?
Yes, I felt it. There are dozens of Earth Pulse points scattered around, but I sensed a few big ones that stood out.
So you can even detect their size?
Yeah, at least I think I can. This island is one of the big ones. There are two more like it somewhere to the east and the southeast, but I think those are the Warg Forest and the Temple of Palamedes.
Still, that suggests we're more likely to find Therians at the larger Earth Pulse points.
We've got three Therians to go. Anything that helps us narrow down our choices is a boon.
Yeah, you've done great work today, Lafayette.
That's for sure. Thank goodness you're here. You're a marvel. One of the wonders of the world, kiddo.
It's not that big of a deal, really.
Then let's go Therian hunting. We have an honest-to-goodness lead.
Or dishonest-to-badness in our case.
Broke again. Still not good enough.
You think it's your swords that are weak? You don't think maybe your body's just stupid tough?
No. If it can't cut me, it's just not good enough. I need stronger materials to make a better sword. I'd love to try orichalcum, but getting that stuff is next to impossible.
Orichalcum. That's the strongest metal in the world, right?
A rare metal that's only been found in ancient ruins, and seldom at that. I've seen fragments of the metal myself, but I've never even heard of a piece large enough to forge into a weapon.
I have. I heard a rumor that a block of orichalcum was discovered in an ancient ruin some 200 years ago. Unfortunately, the boat carrying it sank in a storm.
From the depths of the earth to the depths of the sea.
A sunken ship. Treasure at the bottom of the sea. That would stir any sailor's heart.
If we knew where to find it, could it be salvaged?
The ship's crew drowned, so nobody knows where she sank. Besides, it's a centuries-old rumor. Who's to say it's even true?
Right. No sense in wishing for what can't be gotten. I'm sure there's other material you can use.
Even Dial makes a good point sometimes.
Hey, what do you mean, Even Dial?
Even Dial's getting angry!
Saying it like that's just weird, Kamoana.
Even Kamoana's getting weird!
Alright, so our target is an Earth Pulse point about as big as the one here. Let's start with the closest one and go from there. Which way is it?
The closest one is to the west.
Got it. Lead the way, Lafayette.
My pleasure.
That almost sounded like side mission. What we just heard. That almost sounded like side mission. Should I do that? There is a lot of to do in this game. Too much. And another game is coming out soon. So.
I understand why the Abbey turned this island into a prison. The waters here are filled with rapid sea currents. Make a single wrong turn of the rudder, and your ship will be capsized just like that. Not to mention the fog and all the storms that pass by. It must be nearly impossible to escape.
Aye. To get on and off this island, you'd need a vast store of nautical knowledge and a skilled hand.
Thanks to your curse, Aizen, we've gotten good enough to handle rough seas like this.
The storm that kicked up when we made our escape was huge, and all we had were three novice sailors. Thinking back on it, we had some seriously good luck.
Very good luck.
The first mate told me we're going to be looking for an Earth Pulse thingy, right? The ship's ready to leave whenever. Do you want to depart now?
It's here! This is the Earth Pulse Point!
Nothing but open water as far as the eye can see. Is your Earth Pulse Point down below?
Most of this world is covered by ocean, so of course there'd be a lot of Earth Pulse Points in the deep sea.
But surely even the Abbey would have a hard time containing a Therian underwater, right?
Looks like this one's a bust then.
Sorry, everyone.
Hold on. We've seen a bug Therian. You don't think there could be fish as well?
You may have a point. I think I have just a solution for this.
You do?
This.
What?
Don't give me that look. I'll have you know this is Fujibayashi's rod. This baby's 9 feet long, made from a single piece of the finest bamboo aged 5 years, with a slow 60-40 action that almost feels alive when it bends. Its exquisitely wrapped handle feels like an extension of your own arm. And just look at that elegant black lacquer finish. It's as perfect a fishing rod as there can be.
I'm sure it's a lovely fishing pole, but fishing? Are you sure? This is a Therian we're talking about.
All the more reason. Remember who you travel with.
Okay?
All right. If no one else will, I'm going to veto this fishing idea.
Aw, come on, let's give it a shot. Besides, I'm hungry. Even if all we catch is fish, at least we'll have dinner.
I'd love to have me some koi or sockeye salmon.
Don't encourage them. How do you attach the hook to the line? Like this?
You don't go fishing much, do you?
It's just been a while. I used to go fishing with my brother sometimes.
This is my first time.
Then we can try it together.
I'll teach you how it's done.
I didn't know you could fish, Eleanor.
Yeah, when I was little, old man Tenny taught me. He was from my village. I've caught at least 100 triet loaches over the years.
Wow, that's a lot of fish.
Those two really get along. If I didn't know better, I think she's his sister, not his vessel.
Eleanor certainly got Lafayette's number. Better watch out, Velvet, or she'll steal him away.
Lafayette, let's get the line set up properly. First, you take it and thread it through the hook, like so.
That looks hard.
Hey. Once you get the hang of it, you'll be able to do it with your eyes shut.
Okay, I'll give it a shot.
Luffy!
Huh? You mean me?
Oh, I was just... Be careful there. Wouldn't want you falling into the water or anything.
I'm not a little kid, you know.
It's just that Luffy fell in once, a long time ago.
Luffy? You mean your younger brother?
That's right. You reminded me of him is all.
If you say so. Is that all you wanted to say to me?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay then. I'm going back to fishing with Eleanor.
Mm-mm.
People aren't as easily swapped in and out as fish hooks, are they?
Is that supposed to mean something?
Oh, Velvet! You gotta get it a lot tighter than that. Here, let me take a look at it.
All right. Can I have my rod back now?
Hey, don't rush me here. If I don't get this squared away now, it'll just cause you trouble later.
I appreciate the effort and all, but do you seriously think we'll actually catch a Therian here?
Beats me, but the first mate hasn't met a fish he can't catch.
Huh. Aizen's really that accomplished of a fisherman?
Boat is back, but yes, this is mastered. I have a feeling we need this ability. This is mastered. Scholarly Drive. Oh! That's handy. How is that 9, 10? I need to get the high treasure. And the tarot cards. There's nothing in the cabin, or is there? Let's see. Is there anything? No? Not treasure chest or anything? No? Okay. Never mind then.
If you truly admired the fishies, you'd never dream of doing this to them. No matter how tasty the bait, it's a poor trade for a barbed hook in the lip and a cruel death in the unforgiving air.
I don't admire fish. Fish exist to be caught and eaten, as far as I'm concerned.
Can't argue there. Raw, boiled, or grilled with a little salt. You can't go wrong. And if they're nothing but food to you, even their wretched squirms of agony can hold a kind of beauty.
Old man Tenny sounds like he was a real goofball.
Definitely. He used to say the weirdest things while we'd be fishing, just to make me laugh.
Like what?
Oh, it was all nonsense, but it was funny to me. Silly stuff like papero popero pippity poppity poo.
Yeah, that's silly, all right.
Those two look like they're having fun.
Hey, Aizen, how about a competition? Let's see who can catch the biggest fish.
Don't be ridiculous. Fishing is a solitary battle. It's about meditation and self-control.
Ooh, aren't you the philosophical one all of a sudden?
But I suppose. I can't deny I really want to put this rod to the test.
Yeah, I know that feeling. Whenever I find a good sword, there's nothing I want to do more than to swing it.
Sure enough. There's just something about good equipment that gets the blood pumping.
Yeah. Although in my case, it's usually more like blood spurting.
A bit too much blood either way, if you ask me.
Listen, we're fishing no matter what. Wouldn't a competition be better for getting that blood of yours pumping?
Fine. You're on. But we both know already how this is gonna end.
You can plan all the victory speeches you like, but fishing is like life. It doesn't always go the way you think it will. You ready? Let's do this.
At what point did the Therian hunt turn into a contest?
Hey, Velvet! I've got your rod all set up for you! This thing could even catch a whale if you wanted to. The rest is up to you. Now get out there and fish up a big one.
A Therian, you mean? Might as well give it a shot. It's not like anyone else remembers what we're here for.
Something's pulling the line!
Stay calm. Fishing isn't about strength, it's about timing.
Okay, got it.
Here it comes. You ready?
Damn right I am. I'll fillet it before it can even land.
If it's a Therian, don't you dare kill it.
Now! Heave!
Well, what do you know? Neither a fish nor a Therian.
Well, shoot. Can't eat that.
Oh.
It looks like it fit you, though, Lafayette. Why don't you try it on?
I concur. Maybe it'll bring out his unique personality.
My unique personality, huh?
See? What did I tell you? It looks great on you, Lafayette.
You really think so?
Yeah. Brings out your special charm, kiddo.
Come on. Back to Therian fishing.
Hey, you don't need to take it so seriously.
I have to catch the Therian. Maybe then Velvet will see me for who I am.
Not a bite.
Oh, quit your grumbling. Who was it who said fishing doesn't always go how you think it will?
Spoken like a true, heartless pirate.
Oh, hey! I've got something!
Whoa! Looks like I'm next!
Not a single decent catch.
I think it's decent.
Huh?
You don't take half measures, do you, kid?
What's wrong, Lafayette?
You look ridiculous. Take that off.
Stop it! What do you know about me, anyway?
I know that looks silly on you.
All you know is you're Lafayette!
Hey, Velvet! Something's pulling on your rod!
Huh? Oh!
It's a big one!
Give it everything you've got!
I know what I'm doing!
It's a big one, all right, but...
A pot. Yay. But what's a pot doing out here?
There's something inside it.
Ah! An octopod?
I wish they'd stop. off making those noises.
Watch out! They're armed to the sleep! And they're shouting, freedom ring!
Must you...
There are none who can resist my spear! Phew! That was scary.
Be more careful before you approach a suspicious object.
You think Laffy would have stayed back?
That has nothing to do with this!
Hold on. There's something else inside.
This is new.
We gotta fight the shambling dead?
A zombopod!
For a bunch of dead guys, they're awfully, what?
Yeah. A complete victory!
An octopus army? A horde of undead? What the hell is this pot?
Magnificent. To think I'd get to see one with my own eyes.
Huh? Is there something special about this creepy old pot?
Creepy, you say? That's why these things need to be left to the professionals. Listen and behold. This is none other than a water jug made by the potter Grun during King Claudin's reign. It was a legendary, once-in-a-millennium masterpiece, but it was lost in the Second Warring States period 200 years ago. Assertive, yet not ostentatious, the piece draws you in with its stately curves and the subtle shimmer of its colors, which belie a hidden savagery.
Two lectures in one day?
Yeah. He's talking gibberish, but that's men in general, I suppose.
The lost glazing technique of the Orosaurin is so vibrant, it looks like it could start moving at any moment.
Hello. Tell you now.
It started moving, it did.
Look out! The pot's a demon!
Mercy! Whatever you guys do, make sure you don't smash it!
So, can I slash it?
That's even worse!
Killing Flash!
But I'm this close, I want this! Form Zero! Thunder! Hurricane!
There you go.
I thought we were done for.
There you go. It raises the maximum level to which equipment may be enhanced by 6. Yes.
It's finally decided to behave itself.
Wait, Velvet! Don't eat it!
It's a pot. I'm not gonna eat it.
I guess there weren't any Therians to be found here after all.
Yeah, if there'd have been any, you'd think Ol Aizen's Reaper curse would have drawn him out.
Oh, so that's why all we caught today were weird, useless things.
Right. I forgot about the curse. So all this was Aizen's fault, huh?
Funny how quickly you get used to it.
Oh, my power didn't end up helping us out at all.
Nope. But I know you're not the type to give up after a little setback. Isn't that right, Fee?
Huh? Fee?
It's your nickname. Not a whole lot of thought put into it, but... you're you. You're Fee.
Velvet.
Fee. I like it. It has personality.
Thanks.
Of course, if you still feel like giving up.
No, I'm gonna find us the next Earth Pulse point.
Oh, hey. There's something else inside the pot. This golden luster, it's orichalcum! I get it now. This must be where that ship sank all those years ago. The one Kurogane told us about.
Hell yeah! Kurogane might actually be able to make me an orichalcum sword. Nice find, Aizen. You too, Lafayette.
It wasn't easy, but we didn't come away empty-handed. And just getting a chance to fish again was lots of fun.
Yeah. I had a really good time, too.
Even I was entertained. Especially your little costume show, kiddo.
The sun's going down soon. Let's head back to Titania.
Paint a Google level. This is now mastered. There is nothing else for her to master. No. Must be good.
What else do they have in common?
What are you up to?
I'm compiling everything we know about Earth Pulse points, starting with what the ones in Ward Forest and Palamedes have in common. I'll compare those points with the ones that didn't have any Therians. Then, I'll factor in everything I currently know about the Abbey's deployments. Once that's done, I'll match all that information against what we know about the locations Lafayette was able to sense. When that's completed, we should be able to tell which locations are more likely to house a Therian.
You're really going all out, aren't you?
Must you sound so incredulous? If you're going to do something, then give it your all. There is no other way to live.
Right. I'm counting on you then.
I'm not doing this for you. This is for me and for Lafayette. Do you even understand why that boy's trying so hard?
Yeah, I do.
I spy!
I can't, Kamawana. I've got stuff to...
I spy with my little eye something that starts with V!
Okay, I'll try. Is it... Velvet?
No fair! How'd you do it so fast?
Wait, Kamawana, I'm sorry. You don't have to cry.
Poor Fee.
Have you been practicing your dev impression, Velvet?
What? No.
Now. A performer in Mogilu's menagerie has to be more diligent than that. What if we're stopped at a checkpoint and the guards ask you to perform a trick?
If that happens, I'll show them my trick where I devour an entire witch faster than the blink of an eye.
Oh, that would be a sight indeed. But seriously, if you ever want some magic tricks up your sleeve, let me know and I'll teach you some. Just 10,000 gold each.
Oh, hey, Velvet. You don't mind if I give Kurogane that orichalcum you fished up, do you?
Doesn't matter to me. But do you really think he can make a weapon with that?
I don't know. What does the expert think?
Conventionally, no, it's impossible. But when has convention ever stopped a demon?
I won't argue that.
We're dealing with the hardest metal in existence. But I'm ready to cast aside all doubt. To focus everything on forging my greatest creation.
If anybody can do it, it's you. Good luck, Kurogane.
Yeah, best of luck. If you can make Rokuro stronger, you'll be helping me out too. Hey, what do you say we track down another Therian?
Sure. From what I can tell, the next closest Earth Pulse point is near the center of Midgand.
Midgand, huh? The capital's not far from there. I wonder how things are now that Griffin's gone, though.
Only one way to find out.
Maybe so, but Aizen's not here, you know.
You're right. I haven't seen him in a while. We should probably ask Benwick where he wandered off to.
Yeah.
Hmm? Hold on. There's a letter here. On pretty cutesy stationery, too. Let's just have a quick look-see. As the cold turns bitter and the snow piles up on the mountains, I cannot help but think of you and hope you are in good cheer. As for myself, I am the same as ever, although I recently acquired a rare item that I shall be sending your...
It's rude to read other people's letters, you know.
Yeah, but how else are we supposed to find out whose it is?
Does it say who the sender is?
Uzfamiwu... Wexiv.
Who the hell is that?
Probably someone on this island, if I had to guess.
Hey! Anybody lose a letter?
Do any of these folks look like the type to write a fancy letter?
Point taken.
It could be one of the pirates. Why don't we go to the docks and ask around?
Fine. Just don't forget our mission.
But first...
Hey, Kurogane! Let me ask you something.
More complaining, is it?
Come on, don't be like that. Every time I turn around, Velvet or one of the pirates is telling me to go make some delivery to some island. I can never get a break.
Isn't that just a sign they think you're a dependable guy?
Maybe, but I don't see them sending you off on errands. It's like they take one look at your face and decide to leave you alone.
I don't have a face.
Oh, right, sorry. A slip of the tongue.
Maybe you just don't know how much work I do around here. It's more than you think. Anything to do with iron, I do it. Making tools, repairing things. What do you take me for? Some kind of cheeky freeloader? I don't even have cheeks.
You're too funny. But doesn't it ever annoy you to have all these kids giving you orders?
I've spent my entire life thinking of nothing but forging swords. It's been centuries since I've interacted with youngsters like them. They can be a hassle, but at least it's a new hassle.
Yeah, that's what I thought at first. So I went along with whatever they asked. But I've been too nice, so they keep pushing work onto me. Maybe if I hadn't been so helpful, they would have stayed out of my face like they stay out of yours.
I don't have a face.
That's not the point. Aren't you even listening to what I'm saying here?
You need to make up your mind. You and I got on this ship alongside these people, who are putting themselves in great danger in order to live the lives of their choosing. If you don't like it, then go on and get off this ship with your tail between your legs.
Yeah, except I don't have a tail right now.
Ship has returned.
Ship has returned.
Backfetch. Yes, kill that. Great thing, cuts.
All right. Now it's up to you.
Scout ship departing.
Here. Skill taker light up. Victor light up. Okay. There is nothing here. Not anymore.
This time either?
Nah, but she's doing okay. I can say that much.
That's good to hear. I can rest easy then.
Now's about getting that pot wrapped. I's got this new sunflower printer. How's that sound?
Yeah, that one's cute enough. Let's go with that.
Did he just say cute?
Help you with something?
Someone dropped this letter. Do you have any idea who it might be?
You didn't read it, did you?
Wait, it's yours?
We didn't read it. Much.
You really didn't read it?
No, of course not.
Put this letter in with the package.
Who's got it? When you ship with the Turtles Express, rest assured your mail is in good hands.
If you're done here, we're ready to head out. Our destination is Midgand.
Yeah, I'm all set.
Was he sending a gift to someone? And with a letter, too.
Gotta be a lady friend, that's for sure.
You think? Either way, that letter was really polite. And did you see that penmanship?
Yeah, I didn't know old Reeps had it in him.
I can hear you two, you know.
Ah!
I noticed you've come up with your little name for the kid. You sure are the sentimental type, aren't you?
Oh? Calling him Fee doesn't cost me anything. And it's not like I gave it much thought.
That may be the case, but no one else has taken even that token effort. And in doing so, I wonder if maybe you were trying to encourage him to be his own being. After all, one requires a name before he can consider his own identity. Having been given a name, he realizes he is his own entity, separate from others, and a certain formless essence comes to life inside him. And you're the one who set that process in motion for the kid. Whether you intended to or not, you changed him from a puppet into a living being.
So what's your point?
I've been with you since the start of this journey, haven't I? Wouldn't kill you to give me a nickname, would it?
I've never really thought of us as being that close. And besides, you just forced your way into the group.
Come now! I know you've got a bigger heart than that! Surely you have it in you to give a nickname to a dear friend!
We're not dear friends. And even if we were, I'm not good at nicknames anyway.
Please, I'm begging you!
Okay then. Moggy.
Oh, come on, that's so obvious! Can't you put some heart into it for your dear friend?
Fine. Lou.
Do I look like an old man to you? You're not even trying!
Okay then. Witchy McWitcherton.
Interesting. Well, if I had to rank it against 1,000 other nicknames, I'd probably put it at number 1,011. A nickname needs to have charm. It needs to leave a lasting impression.
Sure then. Hattie.
Now you're just saying what you see!
Bookskirt.
That's not any better either!
Ms. Creepy Eyes.
That's just an insult! Look, no nicknames based on what you see, and especially no slandering!
Little Miss Witch who smiles around you but stabs you in the back when you're not looking.
Hey, that's personal information!
Look, I told you. I'm not good at coming up with nicknames.
Forget it! I should have known this wouldn't work!
Yikes! Better watch what we say from now on.
Yeah.
Aizen, what happened to those octopuses?
Dial and Kurogane took them to the kitchen. They said they were going to make dinner for Kamoana.
They're going to feed demons to her?
Atheria needs malevolence to survive.
That's why they carried them off alive.
What do they plan on making?
Octopus ink pasta with takoyaki and fried octopus on the side, and Helvetian octopus carpaccio.
Do they have a takoyaki pan here at the prison?
Kurogane hammered one out with some iron, along with a large pot for the pasta.
Still looking like that? Takoyaki would hit the spot right about now, though.
Octopus ink pasta, huh?
Like squids, octopuses release ink as a defensive mechanism. But theirs is made of different stuff, and is used in other ways. Squid ink is stickier, and acts like a decoy. But octopus ink spreads out like a cloud of smoke. But squid ink has 30 times the savory flavor, so octopus ink isn't used in pasta all that often.
Luffy told me the same thing. He said that's why octopus ink pasta isn't very good.
Luffy said that?
Yeah, so I ended up not making it for him. But I wonder... I guess it doesn't matter, since I can't taste it now.
I'll taste it for you then. So make me some octopus ink pasta sometime, all right?
All right. And I'll be sure to make some that doesn't come from demons.
Hey, who did Aizen send that letter and cooking pot to anyway?
I don't want to think about it. That walloping still stings.
You've got to be curious though, right?
Maybe.
It was serious stuff. Whoever it is must be important to him. A lover, maybe.
Aizen's lover?
A child wouldn't be happy with that cooking pot, and a man wouldn't want it wrapped up so pretty. A young woman with Aizen's tastes, then. He'd be bound to fall for a miraculous match like that, right?
I don't know. I bet she's that girl with the yellow umbrella.
You really have a thing for her, don't you?
I do not. That's not what I mean.
Then pray tell. What do you mean?
Huh?
eavesdropping, Eleanor? How unseemingly rude of you. Besides, Lafayette is free to like whomever he chooses.
You're one to talk about eavesdropping, Moggy Lou. Anyway, it's just that the sunflower design on the wrapping reminded me of her.
Now that you mention it, but does it really matter? He has someone to write to in any case.
True. I can't help but feel a bit envious.
What a nice way of summing it up, Velvet. So you were eavesdropping too, then.
Say, what do you think about Aizen?
Oh, so that's the kind of guy you're into,
Huh. Not what I'd expect, but...
No! I just feel there's something different about him. The way he picks presents, the objects that catch his eye.
Oh, is that all? Boring.
No kidding. All men have some kind of particular interest, big or small.
I suppose that's true, but he seems a bit, shall we say, overly obsessive?
Now that you mention it, he does have a tendency to ramble on about various topics.
And it's not just the items he collects.
There's more to it?
Every weekend, he eats curry for dinner, and every time we go into port, he docks at the third bollard.
Come to think of it, I heard the galley crew complaining that he always needs his pasta cooked exactly the right way.
And when he needs a new outfit, he always goes to the same tailor and returns with identical clothes and boots. It all has to be exactly the same size and in exactly the same color. Turtle says he's very nitpicky.
Sounds like he's not so much picky as he is a pain in the ass.
But I do see a different side of him now. I thought pirates were all rough and filthy, but it seems they can be quite meticulous.
Not much of a reassessment.
It must not feel great only ever getting tails, I bet.
Nah, I don't really mind that much. It's way too late for me to start letting that bother me.
Yeah, but wouldn't it be nice to get heads at least once? Hell, I know I'd like to see that, and I bet Lafayette here does too.
Yeah, I do.
Right? That's why I've brought something a little special. Ta-da!
What's so special about that coin? It looks identical to the one Aizen already has.
The front side does, yes. But both sides of the coin are actually heads. I had Kurogane make it for me custom. If both sides are heads, then not even the Reaper's curse can stop it.
Well, yeah, but that's cheating. What's the point in getting heads if it's rigged that way?
It's not cheating. It's called effort and hard work.
How?
If you always work hard and never give up, you'll make your own way forward. All right, I'm in. I'll get that heads for you. What?
That crow just flew off with the coin.
Those birds are attracted to shiny objects, I suppose. Damn it! I can't even win against a crow.
Don't sweat it. I figured something like this might happen, so I had a backup ready. Go on, give it a shot. You'll show that curse who's boss this time.
All right, here goes.
I don't believe it! Now Prince Percival's griffin's gone and eaten the other coin right out of the air!
Are you kidding me?
Not to worry. I've got a spare backup. It's time to put that curse on notice.
Right. Here I go.
You gotta be kidding me! Reaper's curse or not, does it really have to go this far over a damn coin?
It's fine, really. I had a feeling it'd turn out like this.
Well, I sure didn't.
Yeah, me neither.
Check the equipment. Yeah, this is only one he can equip. Mm-hmm. Then this one. Do this one, pam pam pam. Comanches. Cat heals. Stream chain. This increases focus. Then let's check the
You got it! Fire burn and cauldron bubble!
Let's make Magilu. Here. We won. No, it was this way. No, I went to the wrong way. No. Okay. This way. There, now I can go down. Down mission. Never mind. I was going to the right way. My mistake. Hello.
Did you ever figure out if that bug was a stag or a rhinoceros beetle?
Actually, I still haven't really looked into it.
Why not? Weren't Rokuro and Aizen pretty curious to find out too?
They're why I haven't. They both have really strong opinions, and they both make a believable argument. And if I determined it was a new kind of beetle entirely, my decision would change the very course of their fates.
Their fates? I think you're exaggerating things.
Hey, what are you guys talking about?
We're still hashing out what that Rhino Stagros really is. Kiddo here is holding off on his final decision because he's worried about how you'll take it.
You're both adults. Can't one of you just give in so we can move on?
It's a rhinoceros beetle. I'm not backing down on that.
No, it's a stag beetle.
Why not just take off the pointy bits? Then we can all agree it's just a plain old beetle. Simple.
Sounds good to me.
Don't even joke about that. If you took away my swords, I wouldn't have anything left. Same thing goes for a stag beetle and its pincers.
And taking away a rhinoceros beetle's horns is disrespectful to its way of life, and to even suggest it is just plain wrong. No, if we're going to argue it out over this, we need to exhaust every possible angle before coming to a conclusion. It's the right thing to do.
Madam Eleanor! Here's that field guide to rare insects of Midgand you wanted me to get you!
Thanks, Bianfu. Surely this book will have something about that bug. Yeah, here it is. This beetle's real name is... Argonathocrassus, the thick-jaw beetle.
It's named for its jaws? That must make it a stag...
It's a drone beetle. The field guide says it's a really rare variety, too. I guess that's that.
No, you're wrong. It's a brand new species. I call it the Lophicet rhinostagros. That's my decision, and I'm not backing down.
Okay, that's that. I think I don't have anything else in anywhere, no, I don't think so. So now we can go to the story.
May I ask you a question?
What?
You're an Earth Moloch, yes? Why live on the sea when your kind sinks in water?
I live on the sea because I'm an Earth Moloch.
I'd be curious to hear more.
Ifrid used to go on about how we should accept what we were born with. But one time he joked about the idea of a pirate who couldn't swim, and he laughed and laughed. I wanted to clobber him right then and there. But it wouldn't have changed the fact that I can't swim. I didn't want some predestined elemental affinity to control who I was. Instead, I underwent tough training to overcome it.
Well, I guess that's one way to approach it. Did this training of yours bear any fruit?
Well, as soon as I stepped into a river, a big flood brought down a landslide from the mountains and swallowed me up. Then, when I tried going into a lake, the seaweed suddenly multiplied and tangled around my body, nearly drowning me. And then finally, when I tried jumping into the ocean, A huge whirlpool formed with me at its very center.
Huh. The Reaper's curse at play?
As far as I'm concerned, my Earth affinity and my Reaper's curse aren't much different, in that they've both shackled me since I came into being. This is about pushing and challenging the constraints I was born with.
Huh. So, did you eventually learn how to swim?
Pretty much, yeah. As long as I never let go of my portable life preserver.
Oh, huh.
I will be right back.
Hey, Aizen, is there, anything we can do about the Prince's hawk? Griffin, I mean. Every day, it goes out on these hunts or whatever, and brings back the weirdest stuff. It's making a real mess out of the deck.
Hawks hunt? What's the big deal?
Well, yeah. At first it was bringing back good stuff like seaweed and fish, things we could cook with. Sure, I was glad for a while. But then it started to escalate. Now we're talking 150 kilo amber cans and 350 kilo killer swordfish that it's catching.
That's not a bad thing, is it? It just means more to eat.
It is when they're being dropped from the sky onto the deck. Especially those killer swordfish and razor-sharp bills. What if somebody gets run through by one?
Can't you just warn the prince that his bird needs to be more careful?
Yeah, we could, but he looks so happy watching his hawk. I'd hate to spoil it for him.
Yeah, the prince looks so happy whenever Griffin is flying free. He kept grinning and asking Grocky all nice-like if he wanted to fly some more.
Grocky?
That's what Kamawana kept calling Griffin. She says she came up with it by combining Griffin and hawk.
This is probably the first time in the prince's life that he's tasted any freedom. His whole life, he's only done what duty dictated of him. Letting Griffin fly was his first free act. To the prince. Grocky is an extension of who he is.
So what are we going to do?
Nothing, really. It's not like it really hurt anybody.
But it's punctured some major holes on the deck!
I'm sure even the prince knows when to rein it in. Let him have a little fun. He deserves it.
I don't know about all that. I'd say the prince is letting his newfound freedom get the better of him. Hey, I was just up on deck and it looks like Griffin's caught an elephant tuna this time.
An elephant tuna? That's the really big tuna that can swallow a killer whale whole, right?
That almost sounds like a demon to me.
Yep. Huge fish, gills like elephant ears. I saw it myself. From the looks of it, I wouldn't be surprised if it was a demon. It's crazy valuable. On a good day, it can fetch 20 million gold on the market. But there's something ominous about seeing it hovering in the air above the ship.
20 million gold? I take back everything I said. The Prince and Griffin can do whatever they want.
Did she say above the ship?
Oh, hell. Benwick, we need to stop Prince Percival.
Aye, aye, sir. Hey! Don't drop that on the deck! Are you listening to me?
That happened. Hopefully everyone is alive and hearty. The skipper letter is a forbidden subject among the crew. Best to leave it alone. And with that warning out of the way, we are ready to set sail. West tunnels. There is something somewhere I haven't been. But I am planning to check the side content. Are you in a place? Altina Plains and Devil Forest. Because I am very curious about the Omega Elixir. At Eleanor. There you go. Something here. Obvious loop. Yeah. I have all the weapons. Let's buy that. Let's buy some ingredients. Oh, ship is returned.
Our starship has returned.
New all right place.
Now it's up to you.
Scout ship departing.
Question, did I find...
I can fight you!
Fine. Okay. Shock ward. Let's give that to her. Thinking, do I have any consumables? What was it? This. Dungeon, head on support cut mix.
tunnel tips. Oh, it's Kulakane's workshop.
Close one, but I am the victor. Don't get overconfident.
There you
go. Let's move on.
There are too many frolic boots. If I'm honest. Thank you.
Gunnish workshop. This way. This way. I don't think we need to save. Aha!
This must be Long Dao's dust. The ingredient Videl's Omega Elixir recipe calls for.
I can't believe you actually found it.
We have to go tell Videl. Maybe he's been able to translate the rest of the list.
Yeah.
Let's go out. I need Can you use the ship for that? Excuse me? Code heads. Let's check this. Daval Forest and Aldina Plains. Grants maximum source, you say. Yes, we can.
Did you guys hear? The search party that went to the Laban tunnel was wiped out by a demon.
Really? They were the ones out searching for Count Capilus, weren't they?
You mean the one who managed to get kidnapped? Despite everyone else at his manor, servants and children alike getting killed? You'd think noblemen like that would have some decent exorcists among their personal guard.
Suppose he did. But I heard every blade there, sword and spear alike, was found chipped and cracked to hell.
What kind of demon could do that?
Who are the Capiluses?
They are one of the great noble lines, on par with Oscar's Dragonia family, and have served Midgand for generations.
People refer to them as the royal family's hidden dagger. Unlike me, you never hear good rumors about them. They say behind the royal family's glory lies blood and tears shed at the hand of the Capilus family.
But those are just rumors. Although I do know that in recent times, the Count had stood against the rise of the Abbey.
I couldn't care less about the whereabouts of some noble, but we should be careful of the demon that took out all those exorcists.
Yeah, it sounds like a worthy opponent.
Where was it? Laban Tunnel. Aha! Okay, let's save.
Wow! Is that Longdao's dust? That's one of the Omega Elixir ingredients! You found it! You really found it!
Yeah, it's proof your research is right.
Thanks! I've just managed to translate the description of the second ingredient. Here, take this and... Oh.
What's wrong? Your face is red.
Hey, you're burning up.
It's fine. I'm pretty much always running a fever.
That makes it even worse. We need to get you home so you can rest up.
But I'm still translating the recipe.
You heard me.
All right. She's scary. Is she your sister or something, Laffy said?
Well, it's... kind of a long story.
Oh, okay. Well, you seem to have a pretty complicated life.
Do you think he's always that sick?
Wouldn't surprise me. I was weak when I was a kid, too.
He's probably been like this since he was born. That must be why his parents named him Videl. It means to live.
Huh. I never thought about that.
Luffy said is like that, too. It means one who lives.
One who lives.
And he wants to be an explorer when he grows up. I feel sorry for him.
But if he drinks the Omega Elixir, I think he can get better. When he sets off on his adventures, will you let him aboard the Von Eltia, Aizen?
I suppose I could cut him a deal.
You'd charge him?
I'm a pirate, kid. Comes with the territory. But I promise you, I won't charge him too much.
I suppose that'll have to do.
One who lives. I did not know that Lafayette's name had meaning behind it.
Didn't mean much in the end. I poured my soul into getting him through. But he's still dead all the same. Hope. What a waste.
You really think it was pointless?
What else am I supposed to think? It won't bring him back.
Next is in Fihal Ice Caps. Oh, bloody hell. But let's do the Legolas Blade next. Next time. These boots are okay now. Not new boots. Okay. save. Wrong place. So I have to continue my way upward. Waste of time. This way.
Well then, let's move on.
I need to sell some of the equipment I have too much. Hello. I don't play fishing, yes. Gonna crayfish. Soup. Got any more meow? Fishing lures. You got hungry loaf on your hands. Be a sport and fish up something to eat for two. Use bait at the fish hole near the hungry loaf. There are three types of bait that can be found as you explore the world. Each type of bait is better at attracting different types of fish. The loaf will eat the fish you catch and thank you by giving you tail coins. Based on the type of fish it was, in addition, each fish hole has its own legendary big one. The majesty of these fish is too much, even for the Lofo, who will not eat them out of own respect. You will gain a special reward for catching every big one. Fresh water shrimp. Bunker. Catfish. Let's see if there's any items. No, I can't. Okay, let's go. Continue, what was this? Can't carry. Aha, there it is there. And Zip has returned.
Take a look at this.
Eye of Newt and Mushroom Spore, tender parts of Prickle Bore!
A new recipe! I've gotta try it!
Scout ship departing!
Then let's choose the dish.
Cooking! Got it! I'll show you the food!
Let's go! There you go. That's eaten.
Cooking.
Oh, there is a place to go down. Color's pink shirt. And gain the title. Nice. Everyone.
a close one, but I am the victor.
Ooh, almost touch you now.
I'll finish this quick.
Finished.
Your style is really unique.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff.
Please don't. The kid's pleasant. Something here, yes, but not the monster. Finish. It's over.
I'll finish this quick.
It appears that we're finished here.
An equipment mastery. Everything certainly is okay, but you can have next weapon. 34. This is next. Aye, aye, aye. It's a nose. Let's go here. And is there something here? Yes, there is. Something. So I need some sort of ability to get there. Got it. Here it goes. There you go.
Cooking.
Yes. Oh, yes. Cats. I found a cat. Hello. Here is the boss.
I don't think we have a chance.
Got it.
I could take it down in 3 swipes.
3? More like 1,000, I bet. This isn't the time to be kidding around, you guys.
I'm not kidding here.
Here!
No mercy.
Come on, really?
Cast heat. Pressing the defend button as an enemy mystic card hits will half damage taken. This effect can be performed on each hit of a mystic card.
We won.
It wasn't good enough.
What do you mean? That demon was really strong.
I don't mean the demon. I mean me. If Shigure were here, he'd have sliced it clean in half.
But you use shorter dual blades rather than just one bigger one like him, so of course...
No. He'd have done it with a shorter blade, too.
You can't be serious.
He's right. I think Shigure might really be capable of that.
Yeah. He's done it before.
Can I ask you a question?
I don't mind. You want to know more about my clan?
Yeah.
Well... As the eldest son, Shigure became head of the clan and ran things for a while. But 3 years ago, a rumor started floating around that he was planning an insurrection, and our lord immediately called for his execution.
Sounds like he doesn't waste any time.
Shigure never particularly cared about our lord to begin with. All he ever respected was personal strength.
Then did your lord send you to do the job?
Yeah. The only thing that can take down a Rangetsu swordsman is another Rangetsu swordsman. I thought I could handle it. I knew his every trick and had the time and place all planned out. But when it happened...
You got your ass beat.
Yeah. He made a fool out of me. I came at him with a great sword, and he just used a small one. All the training I'd done, I couldn't land a hit on him.
A rude awakening if there ever was one.
Damn straight. I couldn't deny it. Shigure cast aside my great sword and just laughed. Train harder, he told me. I was so frustrated by my weakness, my inexperience. So much so that I wanted to end my own life. So much so that I turned into a demon.
Rokuro.
In the end, Shigure escaped, and I was arrested for failing to perform my duty and sent to the prison island.
And the rest, as they say?
So you regret not being able to kill your brother, huh?
I know it sounds crazy, but that's just who I am.
I'm not here to judge you. I'm just using you for my own purposes. As long as you fight my enemies, that's all that matters.
That's the plan. That's what I do best as a demon.
I'm cooking.
Cooking. Got it.
Cooking. Yes. Death Ward. Just another chest, another chest, just. Was there anything else here? I think so not. No. Not interesting, at least. Ice caps. Mm. No, I don't use the bottles. So I continue, I am... Well, I be right back. Let's continue. Collect these. Let's let's go here. Devour.
You're not hurt, are you?
No, I'm fine.
That's good. Returned.
Our scout ship has returned.
Great. Let's do this one Ron Getsu style, guys.
All right. Now it's up to you.
Scout ship setting sail.
Okay. Our next objective is... We can't go there, apparently. Check what this is.
Is that a fighting arena of some sort? I don't see any demons around.
Look! There's something spewing out of the middle!
I sense a really malicious force emanating from it.
It's probably the vengeful spirits of those who fought and died here looking for glory!
Thanks for that. Now I've got goosebumps.
Let's try not to wind up as more vengeful spirits.
Better. I have a better idea. Let's touch it. Here you can battle Vader's specific type of demon. Select summon demons to call demons to the arena and commence battle. After a certain amount of demons have been defeated, more will appear. The battle is over when all demons have been completely wiped out. If you are defeated in battle, you will return to your original pre-battle status. Make sure to prepare yourself thoroughly before stepping up. The first time you clear the challenge, you will receive a reward, so give it your all.
I'll show you the beauty of my spirit! Gaze upon me!
Come back here. It wasn't. All demons defeated. Obtained Virtuoso's Vendite. Allows you to perform a different arts by pressing attack while guarding.
Looks like we won't be joining the party.
I can see why this place is the stuff of cautionary bedtime stories.
Not to mention why the Abbey's keeping way the hell away.
We shouldn't let our guard down. But this place could still be a good chance to hone our combat skills.
Indeed. Most everything we've fought here seems to follow a pattern. This is a good place for tactical training.
If we ever end up on another island like this one, we should probably come prepared for the kinds of enemies we'll face.
Excuse me. Agreed. Let's go check everything. Oh yeah, the equipment. Here. Resistance shoes.
I'll finish this quickly.
Stay quick. Killing blast,
but I'm this close. I won't miss.
What happened?
Yeah.
There you go. You are the victor. Rest Samurai. All team is defeated. Further flight steps. No new boots. Got it. And cooking.
Cooking. Got it.
And let's go to the last aisle. But if I get experience from those, these are good grinding spots. Let's go.
Hey!
refuse to fall here.
Attempting faded. Adventures went tight. Allows the user of Plague Soul Encounter. Use of Plague Soul Encounter attacks a normal difficulty or higher. Got it. Where to next, indeed? The port section was the... one to go, I think. There is still places to go. Map is big.
Hmm? The boss has given me a message for you. Says there's some sort of nasty demon running around in the Aldina Plains, to the east of Logris. She thought it might be the one you're looking for.
Wasn't the Eastern Highway closed off from Logris?
That was only temporary. It's back open now. If you follow the road, you'll reach Stonebury Village. There you'll find one of ours who actually saw the demon. You want to know more? That'd be a good place to start.
Got it.
Hey, that's the same direction I sensed the...
Give Tabitha our thanks.
Looking more and more like we're on the right track. We ought to go check out that Bloodwing story.
Then let's start by going to Stonebury.
Hey, Aizen, did I say something wrong back there?
No. I just didn't think we needed to give the Bloodwings any information for free.
Huh?
He means the Earth Pulse points, kid. We're the only ones who know about them.
But aren't we on the same side as the Bloodwings?
We're not enemies with them. But I wouldn't go so far as to call them our friends, either.
That's just how it goes in the underworld. Things can change at the drop of a hat. A poison hat.
But how are they supposed to trust us if we don't show them trust in kind?
That messenger knew our faces, even though we'd never met. He was here waiting for us, even though we hadn't told anyone where we were going.
You're right!
We hardly know the first thing about them, and yet they seem to know every move we make.
They could easily sell us out if it struck their fancy.
They'll work with us as long as we're a useful ally in their resistance against the Abbey. But the more tricks we can keep up our sleeve, the better.
We've got each other's back, but only as long as we hold a knife up our sleeve. That's what counts as trust in the underworld.
That sounds terrible, but at least you can trust that Tabitha's cooking will be tasty.
Can't argue that.
This is everyone's first time to Stonebury, right?
Why was it blocked off? Demons?
No, there was a great tornado on the Aldina Plains that swallowed up a whole merchant caravan. Hundreds gone in an instant.
The cooling of the climate is causing bouts of odd weather. Thunderstorms, heavy downpours, and the like.
Correct. The Abbey is keeping a tight guard on traffic through the affected areas.
If it's open now, that must mean the tornado is gone.
I wonder what sort of place it is.
It's quite lovely. In the vast forest to the east, you can find gemstones, and it's teeming with rare plants and insects. The locals trade only as much meat and hides as they need, and they live peaceful, quiet lives.
You sure know a lot about this place.
It's where the Norman he first fell in love with grew up.
Yeah! Please don't embarrass me. Though we are apart from each other now, our hearts are still as one.
Immediately after you and I made our pact and set off, she fell in love with some macho Norman and moved away.
What? Why haven't I heard about this? How long have you known?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe I found out during my long search for you. Or maybe it was right after we left. I remember leaving something in the village and going back to... Oh, well, not like it matters.
It does matter!
There's no sense in crying over a fickle girl. Come, Stonebury awaits.
To Stonebury! In.
The Eastern Plain is finally open for travel. I hear that the people of Stonebury are alive and well. My husband and I can breathe a sigh of relief.
I wasn't worried about him at all.
He talks tough, but he was really worried. Oh, sorry, you don't know who we're talking about. It's his apprentice.
What kind of apprentice?
My husband's an architect. Even the royal family and the Abbey commission his work. He's been at the docks here on a job. He just finished, and we're about to return to Logris.
These people don't care about all that.
Why did your apprentice go to Stonebury?
He's young and talented, but a bit eccentric. He said he wanted to help create a new town, so he set off to the frontier.
A craftsman has to focus on his work. Creating a new town. Ha! He should know his place.
But my husband didn't disown him. That boy's fearlessness reminds me of my husband when he was young.
So you understand how he feels then?
I didn't say that. If he thinks he has the talent, he's free to do as he likes. But if he doesn't follow through with it to the end, I'll be done with him.
Did you hear that? He thinks the boy can do it. If you ever find yourself in Stonebury, go visit that boy's workshop.
Right, I'll do that.
Sorry about my husband. He can be a real grump.
Don't worry about it. I'm pretty used to people like that.
Hey, what's that supposed to mean?
I'm so happy things have been peaceful around the capital. I can come to the harbor to shop without fear.
I heard that those demons that made a mess of the palace have been wrecking towns all over, though. But Shepherd Artorias and the fine folks at the Abbey are on the job. I bet those demons are quaking in their britches.
Let's hope that's the case.
Of course it is. Lord Artorias is incredible. The demons have been mostly cleared from the area around the capital.
Your love for the Abbey and the Shepherd are great and all, but I'd keep it down. If you keep poking around the bushes, you might catch yourself a snake.
A snake?
There's a rage-crazed girl out there who hates the Abbey. She's a real viper, that one.
She sounds awful.
That's what I hear.
Who are you calling a viper?
Oh, Muckmutch. No. Ah. Mm-hmm. I think I got it. No, I didn't cut. Exorcist uniform, Eleanor. Fashion. Business classes. Let's go. Denham Highway. East, so probably this way. Emperor Throne.
Take a look at this.
But now I will stop here.
Show us your determination. Well done. I'd expect no less from Ifrit's crew.
All right. Now it's...
Now I will stop it here. I will save. And let's do a raid.
Thank you.
Lake. Okay, thank you everybody for watching, and see you next time. Bye bye.